Back for more Bay Sunday now. Years ago, they were deep in the closet, but times have changed socially, and that's true in the business world as well. The LGBT community is making its mark in a big way, and Celeste Berry is celebrating their success with a very personal book called Out and Equal at Work. From the closet to corner office, it chronicles the lives of LGBT CEOs that are sharing their stories of coming out and taking charge in the business world, and she joins us now. How are you?
Thanks, Frank.
Yeah, glad to have you. How this book's been coming along for a long time, I bet.
It has. It's been certainly an idea for many, many years, but it took about a year to pull the stories together, and I'm thrilled to actually have an actual book now.
And to tell our viewers, you actually sit down and talk to these CEOs from all over the country, folks that have come out, and how they did it and what they had to do to get through the process, their journey, basically, right?
Yes. I run an organization called Out and Equal Workplace Advocates, and over the last 15 years, I've gotten to know a lot of senior executives that are doing this work day in and day out to really make a difference for a lesbian, a gay, bisexual, and transgender people in the workplace. And after getting to know these amazing pioneers, I thought it's time to write the book about Out and Equal and about these people's lives and stories.
And when you approached them, were they excited? Were they reluctant? Was it hard to kind of get inside? Or were they like, hallelujah, let's talk, let's get this out there?
Yeah, a lot of the people's stories, it's just, I think, a tribute to, it really does get better because so many people have gotten to the place where it's just another part of who they are. And they were really wanting to tell their stories for college students, high school students that are still in the closet. And there's certainly people, obviously, all over the country, all over the world, that are deep in the closet, and to let them know that it does get better and that we can bring all of who we are to work if we're able to just say who we are.
And talk about maybe your own personal journey. Everyone's different. It comes out at a different time. You're motivated by different things. Some are in the corporate world. They want to get ahead, and they figure, oh, I can't say that, otherwise, you know, that's not going to work out. Was there one CEO that really touched you somewhere in the book?
The president of Disney World Resorts, and at the time we wrote the book, he was president of Disneyland. George Kalogridis was a busboy at Disney. He started his career, 30 plus years ago as a busboy, and just has made his way through the ranks to now being the president of Disney World Resorts. But he was in a situation where a colleague put out a word on email that he was gay, and that and gave directions to his office, and it became a very big deal. And the CEO of Disney sat down with him and said, first of all, we have your back. We support you 100%. We fired the employee that did this, and we will not tolerate this kind of intolerance. And that was kind of like his wake up call and coming out story,
sure.
Which was was kind of a little crazy making, but he was so thrilled then to be able to bring all of who he is to work every day. And he's just such a great guy, but also acknowledges that people in all levels of the organization are worthwhile and are treated with dignity and respect.
And was there a theme, you think, from each story to each story, really?
Absolutely. I think that everybody's different, like you said, but so many people start out in the closet and then just experience this amazing freedom when they're able to say who they are.
And we talked about it. The generations, the 12 and 13 and 14 year olds say, oh, well, he's gay. Well, okay, that's fine. It's changing.
It is changing.
But there's still work to do, right?
Right, right. And there's still so many people that are in the closet. Certainly the end of Don't Ask, Don't Tell has made a huge difference in terms of the military, and people just, so many more people have brothers and sisters and nephews and parents that are part of the LGBT community and friends. And I think the workplace is a place where people get to know, Marie, and oh, by the way, she happens to be a lesbian. She's a great marketing person, or great at IT, and it's kind of an oh, by the way, instead
of... we get to label this all of a sudden, yeah.
Yeah, this is the only thing I know about you, is that you're a lesbian.
Yeah. Well, hopefully we're getting away from that. The book's terrific. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks, Ryan.
And we wish you all the best with it. If you'd like to get a copy of Celeste's book, log on to outandequal.org. More Bay Sunday right after the break. Stay right there.